Let us now play with this code in the browser and actually see what it's created. I'll be stepping through each line of the dimple code that I just explained and inspecting what gets created at each step of the way. I'll be using the same technique of stopping using the debugger in the middle of the draw function so I can run the code line by line. Just to make sure, let's open up our console here, navigate to the console tab, and then refresh our browser so that the JavaScript debugger catches. As you can see here, again, on line 19, the JavaScript debugger caught. We can go back to our console, make sure that our data has properly been loaded, and now we're ready to start diving in and creating some charts. As I just mentioned, we can use the dimple.chart method to initialize a new dimple.js chart with the SVG element we want to draw the chart into and our data object. If we try running this code, it's going to break, and it's going to tell us that we cannot append to undefined. Now this might seem like a cryptic error, but if you go back to our Sublime text, what we can see here is that the debugger caught before we create our SVG. Now when you're working in this interactive fashion, you have to be sure that you know exactly what's in scope and when. So simply copying this code that creates a new SVG element and appends it to the body, we can paste that into the browser console, and now we have an SVG element. Rerunning the chart creation code for dimple.js, we now see undefined returned. If we inspect what my chart is, we can see a new object, dimple.chart, that has a few properties defined when it prints to the console, and a whole assortment of methods here, which represents everything we can call on a chart or access from a chart. So these are methods and properties like width, x, and y. There's quite a bit here. I don't want to get too deep into it, but I simply wanted to show you that you should not be afraid of libraries and the code that they may generate, but you should be curious and inspect anything, especially if you're working with JavaScript, since things are quite easy to inspect and quite dynamic. If you're interested in knowing the specifics of what each of these methods or properties represents, I recommend reading the API documentation on the dimple.js site.